Leia here from leiaforsci.com/MCAT, and in this video, we're going to look at limiting reactants, including how to calculate product yield and excess reagent. When I learned this topic in general chemistry, I found it very confusing because we focused only on the math and not the logic. It only became clear once I understood what was happening, and that's exactly what I want to focus on today. But first, what is a limiting reactant? The limiting reactant, also called the limiting reagent, is the thing that's used up first in a balanced reaction. Say I have a reaction in which one molecule of A reacts with two molecules of B to give me product C. I have a beaker here with a random number of A and B, and I want to know which is going to run out first. Is it A or B? According to the balanced reaction, we have 1A for every 2B. So that means if I use 1A and 2B, I get one product. A, 2B, two products. 3, 4, 5. And look at that. I have 2As and I only have 1B. I can't suddenly mix it up and say, you know what, for that final one, we'll use 2As and 1B. No. For that last one, I can use half of A with that 1B, leaving me with 1.5A remaining. This means that when B is used up, I still have 1.5A left over. That means I have an excess of 1.5A. And in the process of using up all of B, I had 5.5 products, or a yield of 5.5C, come out of this reaction. Let's work through this again, but this time numerically. If I have A reacting with 2B to give me C, and my starting reagents include 7 molecules of A and 11 molecules of B, even though it looks like I have less of A, and it looks like I should run out of A first, when I run a limiting reactant calculation, where I showed you by crossing them out, we realize that we actually run out of B before we run out of A, and that when we use 5.5 of A with 11 of B, we get a total 5.5 of C products. How did we know that? When we matched up 1A for every 2B, we noticed that we were able to use up all 11 molecules of B and still have a little bit of A left over by comparing them to each other. Now, in your limiting reactant problems, they're going to be more complicated, so we want to use a more mathematical approach. But I want to make sure you first understand what is going on here. To do that, let's use a simple reaction of meal prepping sandwiches, because who doesn't love food? In order to meal prep these sandwiches, we need to follow a very specific and exact recipe. And in this recipe, let's keep it healthy, we'll start with 2 slices of bread, which we'll call reactant B, 3 slices of turkey, which we'll call reactant T, and 5 pieces of lettuce, which we'll call reactant L. Now you take your recipe to the supermarket, but they don't sell them in sandwich kits that has 2 to 3 to 5 bread, turkey, to lettuce. They come in different types of containers. Say you buy a pre-sliced loaf of bread that has 18 slices. We have 18B. You buy a package of cut turkey and realize you have 20 slices. That's 20T. And after separating and washing some hearts of romaine, you realize that you have a total of 25 usable slices of lettuce, 25L. So how many sandwiches does this give us for the week? Well, it looks like we have the least amount of bread, so we'll probably run out of bread first. Is bread my limiting reactant? Let's not jump to conclusions, let's calculate. The first thing we need is a balanced equation. And for this equation, we have 2B reacts with 3T and 5L to give us 1S for one sandwich. With this balanced equation, we now have a ratio of reactants as follows. 2B to 3T to 5L. For every 2 breads, we use 3 turkey and 5 lettuce to get one product, one sandwich. Within this topic, You can be tested on a couple of different things. You can be asked to find the limiting reactant or limiting reagent, and that's the reactant or the reagent that gets used up first. You can be asked to find the product or the yield, and that's simply how many reactions go to completion to give us how much product. And then you may be asked to find the excess reactant or excess reagent, and that's the thing that gets left over after the limiting reactant was completely used up and reacted. In our previous example, because B was used up first, B was our limiting reagent, we had leftover A. That means we had 1.5 excess of A, and our yield was 5.5 of our product C. Knowing this, we have two ways that we can approach this calculation. The first is comparing the mole ratios of reactants to each other, like we did with the earlier example of every A canceled 2 of B. And the second is calculating the max product from the reactants, from each of the reactants, to see which one gives you less product. Both of these options work. It's simply a question of what makes sense in this particular situation, and more likely which one you're more comfortable with. In this video, I'm going to walk you through both. For the first method of comparing mole ratios, we're going to use slices instead of moles, since we're not going to calculate the exact number of grams in every slice of bread, turkey, and lettuce. Instead, we'll set up a ratio between bread and turkey, and then another ratio to lettuce, comparing each reactant to the other one. The reactant I calculate first doesn't really matter, because I like to do a guess and check method. I'm guessing that we're going to run out of bread first because we have the lowest number of bread, but I'm not that confident, so let me check. I guess bread. Now I will check by comparing it to turkey. We'll use the given times ratio method, which you can find on my website, layerforsci.com/conversions, or see the link below. Since we're comparing bread to turkey, we want to start with our given, which is 18 slices of bread, and then multiply that by the stoichiometric coefficients, or the ratio between bread and turkey, which in this case is 2 bread for every 3 turkey. I set up my ratio with 2 bread on the bottom and 3 turkey on top. This allows me to cancel bread and give me an answer in units of turkey. Then we run the math. We have 18 times 3 divided by 2. Remember, on the MCAT, you can't use a calculator, so we'll use some of the shortcuts that I teach in the MCAT math series linked below. We can simplify 18 divided by 2 as 9 over 1, which gives a simple math as 9 times 3, which is 27 divided by 1, 27 turkey. This is what we need to pay attention to. If we used up all of the slices of bread and had perfectly stoichiometrical coefficients in each of the sandwiches, we would need a total of 27 slices of turkey to get through 18 slices of bread. Problem is, we only have 20 slices of turkey. We're going to run out of turkey before we ever get to the 18 slices of bread. This is key. If the number that you get when comparing the mole ratios to each other is more than what you have, that thing is not available in a high enough quantity. That is a limiting reagent. We haven't accounted for lettuce yet, but just between bread and turkey, we know that the turkey is going to run out before the bread, so let's make a note of that. And then we run another calculation. Now, looking at turkey and lettuce, I have less turkey. I can guess again that turkey is my limit, but I want to verify, I want to check by running a turkey to lettuce ratio, just as we did for the bread. Setting it up as given times ratio, my given is 20 slices of turkey. My ratio is 3 turkey on the bottom so that I can cancel, and 5 pieces of lettuce at the top because I need 5 lettuce for every 3 turkey. This math looks a little dicey if we're doing math without a calculator. But remember, on the MCAT, close enough is good enough, so let's take some simplifications. Your first option is to run it all the way through. 20 times 5 is 100, divided by 3. This is a ratio that you should know, and that is 33. If you wanted to simplify, you can say that 20 is very close to 21. 21 divides by 3 very nicely, giving me 7 over 1. 7 times 5 is 35. And look at that, 35 is very close to 33. But what is the unit? If we cancel turkey, we're left with lettuce. Our answer is in units of lettuce. And that's a problem, isn't it? We do not have 33 pieces of lettuce. If we used up all of the turkey, we would require 33 pieces of lettuce, which we don't have. And that means lettuce is our limiting reactant or limiting reagent. How do we know? First, we proved that if we used up all of the bread, we'll run out of turkey first. Bread is not our limit. Then we proved that if we use up all of the turkey, we're going to run out of lettuce first because we don't have enough. Turkey is not our limit. That leaves lettuce as our limiting reagent. The second option is finding the total products for each, which will require a calculation that compares the reactant to the products. That means you're going to require three calculations, one each for bread, turkey, and lettuce. Notice in the last attempt, we only had two calculations to get our answer. Here we need three calculations, which is something to take into consideration when deciding which way to go. So why would you even bother with this method? Well, what if the question asks you to find the total in addition to the limiting reagent? This one is going to find the total in the process of finding the limiting reagent. Once again, we're going to set it up as a given times ratio with one equation for each reactant. We'll have our 18 breads, 20 turkeys, and 25 lettuce. The ratio that we're going to use is simply the reactant compared to the product. Our first ratio has 2 slices of bread for every 1 sandwich. Bread goes on the bottom so that we can cancel out. Our second reaction has 3 slices of turkey for every 1 sandwich. Our third reaction has 5 pieces of lettuce for every 1 sandwich. What does that give us? If the breads cancel and we have 18 divided by 2, we get 9 sandwiches if we use up all the bread. For the second example, 20 turkeys divided by 3 per sandwich, that's approximately 21. Remember, on the MCAT, close enough is good enough. And 21 divided by 3 gives us 7 sandwiches. With the lettuce, we have 25 lettuce. Lettuce cancels, and 25 divided by 5 lettuce per sandwich. 25 divided by 5 is 5, giving us 5 sandwiches. Okay, so what does this tell us? It tells us that if we used up all the bread, assuming we had enough of everything else and bread was the limit, we can get up to 9 sandwiches just by the number of bread alone. If turkey was our limit and we had enough of everything else, using up all the turkey would give us approximately 7 sandwiches. And if lettuce is our limit and we have enough of everything else, using up all the lettuce gives us 5 sandwiches. Based on this information, if lettuce gives us 5 sandwiches, which is the lowest amount, that means that the lettuce is going to run out first, because the lettuce would run out at 5, turkey at 7, and bread at 9. This tells us the lettuce is our limit, which we already knew from the previous calculation, but this is how we found it here. And at the same time, we also found that when all of the lettuce runs out, we have a yield of 5 sandwiches. Knowing that lettuce is our limit and that it's going to give us a total of 5 sandwiches, the next thing we want to find is the excess of each. To do this, we're going to run the same type of equation again, using given times ratio, but this time our given is 5 sandwiches and the ratio is, for every 5 sandwiches, how much of everything else do I need? We don't have to run this math for lettuce because we know we're using it up completely. It's the limiting reagent, and when it's used up, it's completely gone, but I'll show you the math just in case. Our given in this case is our product, 5 sandwiches, times a ratio of 1 sandwich for 5 pieces of lettuce. Why? Because if we get a total of 5 sandwiches and every sandwich requires 5 pieces of lettuce, how much lettuce will we use? We expect to use it all up. Let's see. If we run the math, 5 times 5 is 25. Sandwiches cancel. Answer in units of lettuce. 25 lettuce used up. 25 lettuce provided, completely used up. We knew that, but what about turkey? If we make 5 sandwiches and every 1 sandwich requires 3 pieces of turkey, how much turkey do we need? Units of sandwich cancels. 5 times 3 is 15. 15 turkey required, but we're given 20. So we'll take the 20 turkey that we're given minus the 15 turkey that we use to make the sandwiches for a total of 5 turkey in excess. Now, if you were me, you'd probably just eat the 5 slices of turkey right there while you finish wrapping up your sandwiches. But in a chemical equation, you can't use extra. Everything has to be exact. What about excess bread? We know we're making 5 sandwiches times the ratio of 1 sandwich requiring 2 slices of bread. We run the math at 5 times 2, which gives me 10. Sandwiches cancel, leaving me units of bread. 10 slices of bread are used up in the making of 5 sandwiches. So what does that leave me for the excess? If I have a total of 18 slices of bread minus the 10 slices of bread that I used in my meal prep, 18 minus 10 gives me 8, which means I have 8 slices of bread left over, and that's not something you necessarily want to inhale during meal prep, but hey, maybe you're hungry, right? Now, I know we haven't gone into moles yet, but does the concept of limiting reactant make sense to you from a logical perspective and the type of math that we use in different situations? Do you get where and why before going crazy? If yes, let's try a practice example, but first, give this video a thumbs up and make sure to subscribe and hit that bell icon so you don't miss out on any new videos. Then join me in part 2, where we apply what we learned today, but take it a step further by looking at grams and moles to find limiting reactants, product yields, and excess reagents. You can find this on my website along with the entire reactions and stoichiometry video series and practice quiz. Go to layoffersci.com/reactions or visit the link below. Again, that's layoffersci.com/reactions.